Namaste. My name is Cody. This is my wife, Sarah. We are walking around Washington Square Park right now. The theme of this video was going to be trying new things, stepping out of comfort zones, you know? Just doing stuff like that.
Yeah.
But first we have to find something new to try.
Yeah.
Because we came over here to hopefully find this vegan dosa cart that we've been looking for a few weeks, months really, actually.
Yeah.
Have yet to find it. If anybody knows where this thing is, let us know. But we have yet to find it.
Yeah.
So once we actually find something new to try, we'll check back in with you.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't find anything new to try, except for we did find a Starbucks Reserve to try. But we only tried the same chai that we always have. We're terrible people.
The video will get better, I promise.
Yeah, we weren't there very hungry, so it wasn't really worth really searching to find something new to eat.
Right.
So, just drinking our calories. But
which I love.
So we wanted to try some new things, start some new goals, but you know what? You gotta start somewhere, and that somewhere is not right now. But the next thing on our agenda, I suppose, is a new thing.
Yeah.
Because we're on our way to a company's office to pick up a hard drive because I'm actually going to be doing some editing for them, which I've done, obviously, tons of editing work in my life and in the past, but I've actually never done an editing job for a project that I wasn't involved in at all.
Yeah.
I've edited things I haven't shot, I've edited things that, you know, whatever, but I've never edited anything that I wasn't involved in the project whatsoever, just grabbing the footage and editing something.
Yeah.
So that's something new.
Should be fun.
Yeah. Okay, it's actually like 2 hours later. We went to go pick up the hard drive from the company and ended up sitting there talking about the project and the footage and all that type of stuff for 2 hours.
Yeah.
So now we are home. But the reason we decided to talk about trying new things and setting new goals is because both of us, I don't know, I think it was right after we filmed the video of like being in a creative slump, the video titled A Simple Day in New York, which proved my point.
It has like
three times the amount of views that are, you know, a normal video done. And the reason I titled that was because in the video I say, if I title a video A Simple Day in New York, it gets more views than if I title We Jumped Out of a Helicopter or something like that.
Kind of trolling ourselves.
I was proving a point, and it worked. But
yeah.
Anyways, we were like talking about being a creative slump, and then we both were like trying, reinventing ourselves.
Yeah, I feel like I felt maybe like the last 2 weeks, I just really felt like I need to reinvent myself. Like I need to reinvent myself. I want to be a different person. And so I just like kind of started coming up with new things, not even new things, but just things that have been on my list for a long time, you know? Because I feel like if you're not happy with something personal, like about yourself or about your environment or whatever, like you do have the ability to change it at any point. And I got, personally, I don't know about you, but I got kind of complacent in like where I was and what I was doing, and I just like, I felt the need to change it, so.
Yeah, I was definitely getting complacent as well. If you saw the video, like from two vlogs ago, whenever I was talking about reading we went to Barnes & Noble, we were talking about the books we were reading and how I gloriously missed my reading goal this year. Beginning of the year, I wanted to read like one book a month, at least. And I had at that time read four.
Yeah.
So did very bad. But I decided, you know what? It's never too late to just keep going, to pick it back up, to start over. And so I finished the fourth book that I'd been reading for like 5 months, one chapter at a time. But then I decided to pick back up the Darker Shade of Magic series, and I finished the second book in a week.
Yeah.
And then we bought the third book, and look, this is my bookmark here. So I'm
doing
like
pretty good. You started that like 3 days ago? 2 days ago?
Three, I think.
Yeah.
And I'm already halfway through. And so what I started doing this past week was, or I guess I'm in my second week now, I just decided that I'm gonna cut off work at 8 p.m. every day. No matter what I'm doing, all screen time is over at 8, and I'm gonna read. And so that's what I decided to do. And so I finished a book and a half just by deciding to turn off screens at 8 p.m.
Which is crazy. Also, we did have a conversation where you decided that you're going to try and read more books than me.
Yes.
For the last, like, four or
Well, because I was sitting in bed and I was reading this book, and Sarah was scrolling Instagram or Twitter or something.
It's really a bad habit
of
mine.
Yeah, which it's a bad habit for everybody. That's one part of the reason I haven't finished books this year was because the same thing, just scrolling, like, sitting with the book in your lap, scrolling on your phone.
Oh, for sure,
And so Sarah was literally doing that. The book was in her lap, scrolling on her phone. And so to motivate her, I was like, or to try to at least, I was like, you know what? I am going to read, I'm actually, my new goal is to read more books than you this year. And she was like, okay. but then just now, right before we started filming, I was like, wait, how many books have you read this year? Is it anywhere around like 8? She's like,
no, it's more.
So she's like, it's like 15. And I was like, okay, maybe I'll read more books than you do in the next, before the end of the year.
Yeah.
We'll both start at zero right now. Also, I don't think I'm going to catch up.
I do want to point out that I am gloriously behind on my reading goal as well. Last year I read 35, I think, or 37, and I was like pretty disappointed with myself because I wanted to read 50, and now I'm wishing that like 15 is bad for me. It's been a tough year, guys.
So yeah, we're picking up old goals and rejuvenating them. And actually going to, you know, at least attempt to accomplish them. If not, we're going to be way farther along in our goal than we would be if we just threw it to the wind.
Yeah. John Mayer actually has a quote that says, I think it's John Mayer. He said, if you had started that thing you wanted to start 2 weeks ago, you'd be 2 weeks further than you are now.
Tweet it.
Just saying.
But another thing that besides like picking up the old goal is we've been making some new goals. Sarah's been making some new goals. I have reluctantly agreed to one of them, which is going to the gym. That's coming later. But one second. Sarah just bought a keyboard because Sarah has, well, she took keyboard or piano when she was a child.
Yeah, I played piano for almost 9 years. Fun fact about me, not a lot of people know that I have musical inclinations. But yeah, I played piano.
And I played guitar. Not really.
Yeah, so it's been something. I want you to know we can make it together.
Let the wind blow. All we need is each other. Come and the next step in reinventing ourselves is reinventing our bodies.
Yes.
So we are heading to the gym for the first time in my life.
Yeah, you've never had a membership.
I think I've been to a gym once, but I have definitely never had a membership. But Sarah got a gym membership and it comes with an unlimited guest pass.
Yes.
So that's how we're keeping the cost down.
Yes.
We always have to go together, but we don't have to have two gym memberships.
Yes.
So we're going for the first time.
You can tell he's excited.
Yes. But if you didn't see our previous video about getting a gym membership and why, is because our 10-year wedding anniversary is coming up in November, and we booked a 10-year anniversary trip to London and want to look good. So we just got a couple months to either shed some weight or gain some weight with some muscle or whatever happens with that thing. So for the first time in my life, let's hit the gym. Okay, so here's the thing. I don't even know where to begin at a gym. I don't even know what all these machines do or what I'm supposed to do. So I guess I'm on this elliptical thing. I'm just gonna work up a heart rate, I suppose. What?
I can feel it.
I heard once that it's best to work out the legs because the legs are the largest muscle group. I don't know if that's true or not, but.
Good for me.
Sounds more fun than working my arms. Ooh, I've worked up a sweat. Machine's on the cool down. My BPM has made it to 130. Didn't really change much, but I'm sweating. And I've officially completed my first gym workout.
We did it. I went further than you.
Whew! Ooh, my legs feel a little bit like jello.
Yeah, I can feel it, but that's good.
But I think now I'm just gonna go ahead and make my way over to the CrossFit gym and sign up. I'm ready.
We're prepared.
Also, if you have any gym tips or working out tips or things that I'm doing wrong, keep them to yourself. I don't really care. I was at the gym. That's all that matters. And for a post-workout cliche meal, got Chipotle. But as you can tell, we've had Chipotle before, so the day of new things has ended.
Yes.
And we are going to go home, eat this food, probably continue reading my book.
Yeah. I was going to say, we're going to read.
Yeah. The day is not over, but this video is. Hit the like button, subscribe for not. We make videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on this channel. We also do a podcast called Deeply Curious. You can check that out by going to podcast.codyjensen.com. Also check out our merch at shop.codyjensen.com, and we'll see you in the next one.
Bye.